In this video, I'm going to show you how to import an asset inside of Unity, also how to create a material, and also how to import an animation set inside. So let's get started. Okay, so to create a new project, all you need to do is you need to go to New and call this, I'm going to call it Demo Game. You can call it whatever you want, really. And then I'm going to include effects environment, cameras, and particle systems, and click done. Click create project. And I'm going to let this load and then cut to when it's open. Okay, so once it's loaded in, this is your standard Unity layout. Now you can change it and customize it however you want. So if say you wanted to move the game thing back up here, you can do. I tend to keep mine down here, especially when I'm testing, but not that. And you have this the scene mode. This is where you drag everything in. So all your assets you can drag into here, drag into this hierarchy down here. This is pretty much a bit like the Unreal Outliner. So everything that's in your scene, pardon me, will be inside of here. Then this, once you want to play the game, so if I wanted to play the game, it's not going to really do much. This is where you'll see the game playing. Which is a bit like a play-in editor in Unreal. You also have your project file, which has everything that you put inside of here. So in here I can actually create folders to help with organization. So if you want to create anything in any of these menus, if you just right click, go create, and you can create a range of different assets inside of here. Now to begin with, I'm just going to create a folder. I'm going to call this furniture. Okay, now if I click in here, what I can do is I can create another folder called textures. Materials. Just to keep things organized. Now to import an item, we can go import new asset and navigate to where, so it's right click, import new asset, and then navigate to where your thing is. Let me just organize my folders a little bit. There we go, that's what I want. I'll just go to my and I'm going to go to here. So this is this assets from a project I'm working on at the moment, and this was modeled by Reese, who's working on the project with me. But I'm going to show you how to assign a material to it, and that's pretty much how you import. You can drag as well, so if you want to, if you've got an FBXE, you could drag it into here, but it's entirely up to you. But you'll see that it's come in with materials. Now we don't want this. This is a folder that brings the materials from Maya into it. Now there's no other way of doing this until it's in the engine. So what you need to do is first delete this folder. If you leave that folder in, it's going to be very messy and your programmers are going to get confused on where things are. Also, to turn that off from future, is if you click here and then click here, that stops it from importing in. Now, sometimes as well, there'll be an avatar inside of here. Now, if it's an animation, that's fair enough. If it's an animated object, you need that avatar. But for static stuff, you don't need that. So one way to get rid of it is to go to Rig and click None. Now, if this has been come in, it'll come in as a generic. Let me click apply. There you go. This is the thing that you don't want with a static object. So you just go into Rig, click None, click apply, and that will get rid of it. And that's pretty much how you import a asset inside of Unity. It's quite straightforward. Now, if you want to drag this into scene, you can do. I tend to drag into the hierarchy first. Okay, so we have our sofa. Now, the only issue is that Unity really works with something called prefabs. So to create a prefab, what we can do is, if you right-click in your project folder here, I just deleted the sofa from the scene, click prefab and call this sofa prefab, and then drag this FBX over the top of it. Now you've got a prefab. And if we were to drag this now into the scene, there you go. So you keep your original, and anything you do on this changes it. So one thing I am going to do is I'm just going to drag this mesh out of the prefab, delete the prefab, and just replace it, okay. The reason for that is that it's come in through a hierarchy, so you want to not have that hierarchy in there, so that's why I've deleted it. So now we've got this prefab. Now here we can assign new materials. So just like in Unreal, if you've got multiple materials, you can assign it here. So let's import the texture. So I'm going to go to my textures, import new asset. I'm just going to navigate to the materials folder, crime scene, which is here. Let me remove props, sofa, and... Now the problem with this method is you can't select more than one thing. So actually, being able to navigate to where it is here and go, where are you? Images. Sofa. And I can drag it in just like that as well. Okay. Now I'm going to create a material. So I'm just going to right click, create new material, and call this sofa mat. Now, just drag and drop. That's all you need to do on these materials. Now, one thing, the normal map will come in. The texture is not marked as normal map. If you click fix it, that'll fix it. And then select your prefab and just drag onto here. There you go. That's how you assign a new material. Now, with this, it's a little bit different. Obviously, with the material, you have all your slots, so your albedo, your metallic, your normal, your occlusion, your emission. Now, metallic, it works a little bit differently in Unity. I'm just going to have to show you how we can actually change that. So if I load up this map, so in Unreal, it's best to work with a packed specular map where everything's in your RGB channels like this. But with Unity, it's a little bit different. So I'm going to create a new folder. I'm going to call this sofa metal texture. Okay, click OK. Now, because the sofa's not metal, I'm going to color this black. White means it's metal, black means it's not. And then I'm going to take my roughness map, which is this one here, and copy that into an alpha channel here. And the reason for this is because you need this to be in the alpha channel. It'll read this off the alpha channel. So then, file, save, and let me just navigate out of my other project folder. Crime scene, images, props, sofa. I'm going to make sure that's set to save. Make sure it's a 32-bit because it needs to have the alpha channel saved. Now I'm going to drag this in. So where are you? There you go. And with that material, I'm going to assign it to the metal. So let's try something extreme. So create a new folder, a new texture file, and let's make sure merge that, let's hide that, and then let's grab that and pop that back into the alpha channel. See if this works. Now, if you want to find the explorer, if you right click here and go show in explorer, it will load up the folder that's associated with this, he says. There we go. And if I double click on textures and find that, Control C, Control V, replace the file, it will automatically update the file. And there you go. So the darker the roughness map is, the less shiny the object is, so it works opposite to Unreal. So the lighter the whiter the roughness, or the spec, the shinier it will be. So if we go back and change that, so if we let's try that again. So you can also see these meta files. Now, this is really important that you don't delete meta files, because it will screw things up. Okay, did that do anything? Try this again. So put the original in. And there you go, it's more shiny. So that's how you set up the roughness in here. It's a metallic workflow. So obviously if there was metallic, you'd have white bits on the metal map to show where the metallic is, and then the rest would be black. And that's pretty much how you set up a material inside of Unity. I don't think you'd be doing anything more than that with shaders, unless you really wanted to have a go at creating your own shaders. But there are different versions of it, and also if you wanted to, if you've got an alpha, you put the alpha in the 32-bit of the albedo, which I'll show you that now, actually. So let's import a new object. So import new asset. Game, you have to delete this. Click apply. Just going to create a prefab as well. worry about that. And again, I'm just gonna replace that. So let's now you can also snap by holding V. So you can snap points again. You hold V, drag it to where you want, and then drag it to wherever you want to snap it. So let's import this in. So just to be careful, let's just open the, just make sure the fireplace has the alpha. New. So where are you? So I'm just going to control C, control A to select it all. Then I'm just going to copy this into the alpha channel. Would help if I actually had the layer selected when I did that. That might be why. I'll put this to pixels. You can see that it's 1024. Let me just convert that back. Let's try that again. Copy. No, you don't want to do this. There we go. So I'll save this out again. I'm just going to save this as a copy. Save it, and save it as a 32-bit, and I'm just going to drag these into the scene. I'm going to create a new folder, material even, sorry, and call this fireplace. That. I'm going to drag this on the albedo, and I'm going to drag this on the normal fix now, and then I'm going to drag that on the default material there. Okay, so at the moment the alpha is not showing up. I forgot where the alpha is even on this. So we change this to cut out, and there you go, and that will create your cutout. Again, if you want to create a transparent, you can do, or opaque to get rid of the alpha, but it is cut out. So let me just fix the metal for this so we can see the metal working for it. So where's the metal? There we go. Let's grab the roughness wherever you are. So here we go. Again, you save this out. So fireplace. Okay, 32-bit, and let's load this in. So, where are you? Should really call it metal, sorry, but okay. And now the metal's been defined, and you're also getting, but we can change the alpha cutoff as well. Probably want that about there, but yeah. So that's how you create materials, import assets inside of Unity. Now, one thing I did say is, I'll just show you one more thing, which is if you've got an asset which has got animations. So if you go create, import new asset. And I'm just gonna navigate to my Sure14 art folder. Again, delete his materials folder, delete the materials folder, import, click apply. And we don't have to worry about the rig, because again, no animations, so you can go to the animations tab. Animations in Unity are best used if they're in the whole folder, like one file for the whole animation set. So every time we update this animation set with new animations, what happens is Charlotte will actually send me a file with all the new updated animations added onto this FBX, and we just replace the FBX. Now, in a later video, I'll show you how you can actually take this and split it. But for now, pretty much to bring in an animation, animate it in Maya, have it as in one file, and then this is about 500 frames worth of animations that we use for sure footing. One thing that you might need to know is how to save the project. So if you go save scene as and create a folder called scenes, help if I could spell, and then just name the scene furniture test scene, click save. There you go, and if you want to create a new scene, just click new and it'll create you a new scene. Thanks for watching this video. Hopefully it's given you a little bit of an insight on how to get started with Unity from an artist's perspective. A lot of the time you will need a programmer to help you with Unity, because there is a lot of programming involved in the engine. But you can still create some really nice looking games. Do check out the Unity website, because there's a lot of example games on there as well. So thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.